2018 marks the 75th anniversary of the worst naval disaster of World War II, and there is a Mid-South connection that chances are we bet you've never even heard about.
The sinking of the Rohna killed more than 1,000 U.S. soldiers, many of them members of the 853rd Battalion, which is stationed in Dyersburg, Tennessee, and the whole thing was kept secret. Even the folks at the Halls Veteran Museum and Dyersburg Historical Society had not heard of it before Catherine Ladnier brought it to their attention. She's written a play called Apron Strings. It will be performed at the Rohna reunion this weekend.
And her Uncle Bill survived that disaster. Catherine, welcome to Live at 9. Glad to have you
here. Thank you so much.
A lot of people are going to be wondering, first and foremost, why was this kept a secret?
It was the first deadly attack by a missile.
Okay.
In the spring of 1943, the Nazis had started to experiment with guided missiles. There had been two hits prior to the Rohna, but the Rohna was deadly. The Rohna was part of a convoy on its way to the China-Burma-India theater, and it was hit on November the 26th, 1943.
So because it was hit with a missile, this was a new type of weapon?
It was the beginning of the missile age.
And so was the government afraid of what, if the word got out?
What some of the survivors have said, and what has been written, is that there was concern by both Roosevelt and Churchill that news on the home front would be devastating.
To the Allies? Mm-hmm.
To the Allied cause.
Wow.
And would seriously hurt morale on the home front.
Wow.
And they were not allowed to write about it.
So even the folks in Dyersburg, whom you contacted, and the Veterans Museum and Halls, they had not heard of it.
No, they had not heard of it.
So what about the families?
Wow.
How were they impacted by all of this?
Well, I first learned of this through a letter that came from...
Here, let me hold up some of those letters. These are letters from your Uncle Bill to your mother?
Yes, and the first letter I received was from a lady, Mrs. Leach, in Oklahoma City, and she sent out a mimeographed letter to the officers of the 853rd Engineers Aviation Battalion in which she was seeking information about this incident in the North Africa area.
So what type of response did she get, at least at that time?
Well, she might... Then, sometime later, I found a letter that my mother had responded to Mrs. Leach.
Gotcha.
And the government sent out notice that your son, husband, brother is missing in action in the North Africa area.
Gotcha.
So a little bit of information had gone out.
Look at this letter. This is amazing. This is an envelope that on one side.
It's actually postcards.
Oh, there are postcards in here? Okay, so check this out. It's the skyline. I mean, the skyline really hasn't changed that much.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So you have two 97-year-old veterans coming to the reunion.
Yes, we do.
One who was on the Rohna and one who was on the ship
Gus,
that came and rescued?
Gus lives in Baton Rouge, and he is a survivor of the sinking of the Rohna. And we have a new veteran coming, whom I sat with last night at dinner, Hal Johnson from Jackson, Mississippi, who was on the Banfora, which was part of the convoy.
Right.
And of the convoy, Rohna was the only one that was hit.
So what do they want us, in your estimation, Catherine, to know about this incident, this tragedy?
To tell the story.
Yeah.
To tell the story so that people know what happened. Because you can go to the Memphis Library, and you can pick up 20 books on World War II.
Yep.
Go through the index. You'll find nothing on the Rohna.
Mm.
More than 1,000 soldiers died.
Yes. The largest unit on the Rohna was the 853rd Engineers Aviation Battalion.
Based in Dyersburg.
Which was formed in Dyersburg. And Uncle Bill was a lieutenant on the base, and he was in charge of equipment. The enlisted men came from Bradley Field, Connecticut, Hartford, Connecticut, and I live in Connecticut.
Right.
Connecticut Historical Society has nothing on it.
Wow.
That's
very quickly.
The FDR Library has nothing on it.
We mentioned a little bit earlier, you have written a play about this. What's your take on the play?
Well, what they went through.
Yeah.
You know, my mother was on the home front in South Carolina, taking care of Uncle Bill's hogs, so to speak.
Yeah.
Aunt May spent the war years in the Blue Ridge Sanatorium. And she was always writing about, I'm feeling great. And Uncle Bill was always alive and kicking.
So it's the story of a family kind of caught in limbo with no knowledge. Thank you for bringing this.
And we know these people made sacrifices.
Absolutely.
They had victory gardens. Mm. They counted their ration points.
Absolutely.
And we don't do that today.
They saved the
world.
It's
a fascinating story for sure. Catherine, thank you very much for sharing it with us.
Fascinating.
You
two are invited to the play, and we did put the information on the screen. It's Friday. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.